Hello and welcome to the show. I am here on GTA 5 with another Daewoo. Yes, the Daewoo Tico, I think that's how it's pronounced, is going to be going up against the army. And Daewoos have done very, very well against the army in the past. The Nibiru was the first car to ever survive the dangerous road with the army giving chase. The Laganza had a massively long chase all around the city, survived all of it, and got away. So this car has certainly got an awful lot to live up to. I do fear for it a little bit. I did a little bit of test driving just to make sure that the mod worked and everything. And the car is very, very fragile. So a couple of solid hits from the army vehicles will very, very much kill this car. Or could do if they're heavy enough hits. So gonna have to be very, very careful with that. The plus side is it's relatively decent speed-wise and relatively decent agility-wise. Can change direction quite nicely, and because it is so small, it will be able to fit through very, very narrow gaps that the army vehicles won't be able to follow. It is incredibly light, and off-roading is a slight scare for it. It kind of gets bounced around quite a lot when we are going off-road, so I probably won't be going off-road if I can help it, although I may end up having to do so to avoid... Oh, wow. Bloody hell. The bushes just stop it dead. I would rather go off-road and be bounced around than be fighting against a large number of army vehicles, because the collisions from them are likely to be what kind of kills this car. There's also a huge amount of custom parts you can put on it. As you see, I've gone for the silly stuff with... a ridiculous wig, a ridiculous exhaust, and some off-road body kits. There's lots of mods you can do to this car. It's a really rather cool mod. Oh, don't get too slidey. Oh, no, we're going to go for a spin. Quick, there we go. Found reverse, got it going again, and we are fine. Oh, hello, Crusader. Hello, Barracks. Ow! I thought I could get across in time. I could not. It now kind of looks like a Renault 5. the back. The damage is impressive on this car. Well, we're going this way, apparently. Oh, no, there's a bush in the way already. Ah, we've rolled our way into the scrapyard. Sounds about right somehow. Yeah, you see what I mean? About one big hit can get you in a lot of trouble with this car. I'm going to go over here and maybe find a way back onto the motorway. Let's go to the... Don't just give up and drive straight into the prison, right? I surrender. We've also... I'm not sure of the way that this is damaged. The car does kind of look like it might fall over. It might go on two wheels when we turn to the left. We're certainly going quite a long way onto two wheels at one point around one of those corners. So I'm hoping that's not a thing that we have to deal with particularly. Okay, we're alive though. We have made it back onto the motorway just about intact. The suspension is very, very soft on this car, so it does kind of wibble and wobble around a bit more than some of the previous vehicles that have gone. Also, the gear ratios are kind of strange. It just sounds like it's buzzing in the limiter permanently. It'll do about 85-ish miles an hour, which is okay for a GTA 5 car at least. Hopefully it might be enough to get past the army here. I'm going to go for the slowdown tactic. Oh, slowdown tactic and big oversteer moment tactic. It's not quite working here, because I would really rather not get involved in a crash with the army cars. Quick, out accelerate that scary sight that is behind us. Uh-oh. This is not good. We have army vehicles every which way. Okay, you've moved, which has made my life a hell of a lot easier over there. They're kind of moving soon enough to cause issues for me. With one of them, I can just about outmaneuver them, but this lot here is going to be bad. This lot here is going to be really bad if they timed it right, which they didn't. They've managed to all block one another in. Somehow, despite the damage, we're having to weave down the road to stop a car from rear-ending us. Somehow, despite all of the damage, the little Daewoo is going to make it into the city. Almost. We've almost got there. Don't celebrate too soon, because we're not quite there yet. Okay. Well, we've lost some more bodywork on the front of the car, but never mind. Never mind. We've made it into the city. We've spun. Oh, we've corrected it. We've lost the army very briefly. Oh, please let this work. I'm going to hide in a bush. Yep, I parked here. The army will never see me. Absolutely never possibly see me here. Oh, crap, there's an army car coming this way. Hide, 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 hide. Yeah, I'm totally, totally hidden. There's not even an army car. Oh, that might be an army car. There is not an orange Daewoo hiding in a bush. Not at all. Go away, army mess. Oh, bugger, he did see me. It was worth a try. That actually works surprisingly well. Please let me go under here. Okay, there's not an invisible wall. That's always good. Oh, crap. Hello, guys. Don't mind me in the little Daewoo. Things are going not quite to plan at the moment, I will be honest. We're in a lot worse shape than I had hoped getting to the city, but we are still working at least. Christ. Brakes, ow. Ow, with the damage. And the, well, at least I got on the brakes enough to slow it down so that damage wasn't too bad. Where are we going to go down here? That is the next question. How are we going to lose the army once more? I wonder if I could probably have got down there if I could have turned the car soon enough. You see, I can go down. Whoa, that was close. We've lost the boot. The boot's gone. The back of the car is at all sorts of a funnier an angle. That's not a good sight. We don't want to be seeing that. Go away, please, cars. Please leave me alone. Please leave me alone. Maybe if we hide down one of these alleyways, you'll get confused and leave the poor or completely and utterly abused Daewoo alone. We've lost the bonnet now. Oh, Christ. There's sort of like debris around that is causing massive issues for this car. That's an army vehicle that saw me. Damn it, I was going to try to get over here, but I couldn't get going in time. I could get going in time. There's just too many army vehicles around already. Oh, that was a big puff of smoke. I think the Daewoo may have had it, just ever so slightly. Hey, guys. I'm going through this little gap here. Don't mind me, okay? Thank you. And now if you could block the road off for everyone else, that'd be really awesome. Okay, we're good. We're still going. We're slightly smoking. The barracks is kind of crashed a little bit there. Oh, lots of smoke is coming out of the back of this car. Wonder if we go up here. Oh, we're going to clonk the wall. No, it's died. It's died a terrible death. Oh, I was going to go up there and hide around the corner and the army wouldn't have found me. And yeah, there's quite a lot of smoke coming from the Daewoo. This is going to be a tough one. This is going to be a really rather tough vehicle to get away from the army. Also, why on earth have you given up? Oh, there's a small bit of fire. Hey. I never stopped shooting because my car was on fire. Well done. What is the girl is going on here? Yes, I shall punch you in the face. You have a gun, so you decided to run up and try and... never mind. I will never understand the army. Okay. Second attempt, we'll have to be more careful, I think, with the vehicle. So, if we are to outmaneuver the army, I really cannot take very much in the way of damage. It's probably going to have to be quite a quick chase if I am to get away. The longer the chase goes on, the more likely I am to bump into something, whether it be an army car. They're the most scary things because of the speed and the weight of those things. But, I mean, I just slid it into a wall and that's what eventually killed the vehicle. So, we've got to be really very mindful of the damage and hell. Some of like the debris, I think, was causing issues for the car down some of the alleyways. So, yeah, this is quite a weak vehicle. Not quite the ludicrous levels of weakness that I've seen from some of the other mods. It was the Bobcat I had the extreme damage on that sort of one hit, and that was very much you out of contention. It's not quite that bad, although I have no doubt if the if a barracks went sort of flat out while I was stationary, that would probably ruin the car. Whether it exploded it instantly or not, it would probably buckle a wheel up and make it undrivable. So, yeah, definitely going to have to be very, very careful with this vehicle. I'm trying to think of what's going to be the best potential way of getting into the city. Now, the motorway is great on the most part. Oh, that's gonna really hurt. Ah, oh, come on, Daewoo, we're fine. Oh dear. How on earth that is still working? That barrack, not the barrack, the messer was completely committed. Normally they don't come for such high speed. Wow, they are really throwing their cars at me today. Bloody hell, what has gotten into them? They are not letting the Daewoo get away this time. We're leaking fuel. Wow, we're on fire. Admittedly, I think I might have set fire to myself there. Yeah, they are determined not to let the Daewoo get away. That was well done, army dudes. Well done. You were committed and incredibly efficient at mullering the Daewoo. Unfortunately, not very well done for me there. Well, that may have possibly been the quickest chase I've ever had in this series. Those messes can be really rather mean if they are going at high speed directly towards the car. Two hits. Two hits is all it took. I'm amazed it was still working after the first one. Unfortunately, I couldn't get it going quick enough to get it kind of out of the way. I may have to go for some slightly alternate tactics with this car. As much as I don't want to take this off-road, I may have to keep it off-road in the hope that I can keep it away from the cars. They do just so much damage to this. Inside the city, I'm all right. Once I get to the city, I can... provided I don't drive it into a wall myself, I've got to worry about, other obstacles. I can probably outmaneuver the army cars, though. It'll be too crowded, it'll be too busy for them to really do that much about the Daewoo, but on the open roads, that's where we're going to have some potential issues. Down this motorway. I'll give it another try. It's just the quickest, most efficient way of getting into the city, and the least time I can spend exposed to the army vehicles, the better. This is going to hurt. Oh, just about. Oh, that messer was going for it. God, they are absolutely on it today. They are... They do not want to be embarrassed by another Daewoo, and they are completely and utterly committed to outmaneuvering this particular one. Oh, go on, barracks. Oh, I didn't drive into the side of the messer. Disappointing. I shall use the civilian car for cover. That actually worked out quite nicely. Thank you. And the barracks is in the trees. Now, where do I go here? Kind of tempted to go off-road, but that will... if I go off-road, I think I'm going to have to. I think I'm going to have to go off-road here, because otherwise just the survivability on the motorway is so slim that this is probably my best option. Now, we are likely to bounce and probably spin multiple times down here, and the army cars are giving chase. This is not fast enough to simply outrun them by going over here. Some cars have been. This one is not going to be. But it means that I can survive, hopefully, for a little bit longer. I can survive with less damage done to the vehicle by the time I get to the... Wow. Wow. They're just barreling along and then insta-stop. Unfortunately, we are a lovely target for the helicopters to just fire many, many bullets. And because we're not particularly fast, most of them are hitting. Whoa, hold it. That's an interesting spin there, car. Come on, get going again. I need you to move a bit quicker than this. Okay, if you spin out from time to time, I'm going to just have to deal with it. But if we could get moving again quite quickly. God, the bushes and the twitchy. It's quite a twitchy car to begin with, as you can imagine, with such a tiny wheelbase and rather sort of bouncy suspension. It can get quite unhappy. But yeah, with these bushes are really, really not helping matters. Okay, we're going through the... can't remember the guy's name's house, his ranch or whatever. We're going through there, no problem. We'll lose the bonnet for good measure. Oh, going down here probably was not a good idea. Somehow it's back to pointing the right direction again. Who knows? Come on, climb the hill. Climb the hill. There we go. Oh, crap. I don't want to be going towards the road just yet. I want to be staying over here for as absolutely long as possible. Okay, that wasn't a trail of fuel I saw leaking from the car. Oh, tree! Ow. Wow. Car's on fire already. This is quite difficult. This is... Yeah. That's a lot of fire already. I think we might be in trouble. The Daewoos might be in trouble with this one. Well, it is safe to say things are not quite going to plan for the Tico. It's... doesn't really survive very long. The Banshee 900R took quite a lot of damage in its runs. It didn't take very much for that car to have issues, but this thing is, yeah, really, really quite weak. If I can get it to the city in one piece, I think I can probably outmaneuver the army. I think I can probably do it with a car. It's got enough speed and it's got enough handling that I will be able to outmaneuver them. If I can survive long enough to get there, and if I can survive long enough to outmaneuver them. I mean, it lost them coming into the city, it lost them down some of the alleyways, just had nowhere to hide. So there certainly is potential if you can get in the right place. It may have to come down to the car park. It probably would be able to. But it's about surviving long enough to get to that stage that I think might be this... This car's downfall. I'm going to try another way of getting into the city. Now, this road, I tend not to go down particularly. There are dangers with heading the direction that I'm going to be heading. While there are likely to be less army vehicles, I'm also going on a single carriageway road, which means what army vehicles there are perhaps pose a greater threat. Whether it's going to work or not, I don't know. I normally don't have to do this, because normally the cars can at least survive going down the motorway. Oh, bugger me, that's not what I wanted to do. Never had a car that gets broken as quickly as this, where the barracks completely and utterly mullered a tractor back there. That was fantastic. And, alright, we've got a lot more army vehicles than I was expecting going to the post. Thank you. Thank you so much for doing that, army car. By heading down here, I was kind of hoping for less army vehicles. That has not been the case. I may end up having to try and stick it off-road all the way down here. It's not really an ideal way for me to be going, because we are going to roll the car if we're not too careful. There is kind of more space, though, to move either side of the road so I can hide better and just generally confuse them slightly. That's my best tactic, really, at the moment, but it's not the strongest of tactics, I will be honest. Oh, this is going to hurt if he gets that right. He got it completely and utterly wrong, so that's good. We're going off-road exploring some more. Oh, no, we've got to be careful of the the very solid bushes. They could completely and utterly screw me over in this particular off-roading thing. I mean, me jumping into a tree killed it last time, so solid bushes are not too far-fetched thing to drive into. I may be tempted to complete the rest of this journey off-road. I think I'm going to probably fare better if I do so, because yeah, I can hopefully take the few bullets from the helicopters better than I can deal with the damage from the cars. If we can stick the wheels on the train tracks, we can get a little bit of speed. Just please don't let there be a train coming towards me. That would not end particularly well for anybody. Well, I mean, the train probably wouldn't notice the little day you go sailing past or forwards. Well done, army car. You're going the wrong way. You messed that one up completely. A little bit of peace and quiet. Now, there is a road, I'm hoping, to the left-hand side up here that we can dive down. Helicopters have not done as good a job at shooting me as I was expecting. I will be honest, I was thinking we're going to be taking a hail of bullets most of the way down here, but they just haven't done very much at all. The road that we want to be heading down is beneath us, I think. I don't know if I don't want to go crash through anything. Whoa, big explosion. Wasn't my fault, that one. It actually wasn't my fault, that one, for once. Yeah, the road is down there, but I have got to be really careful getting down to it that I don't break the car. I haven't gone this way in a very long time, so yeah, don't mind me while I slightly have some off-road issues. There we go, we're fine. The helicopters are still not quite in a position to really shoot at me, so we're surviving this quite well. I want to get down to that road quickly, but I don't want to get down to the road via the very, very bumpy, rocky path. I want to take as smoother a way down here as possible. There we go, this is what we're talking about. That's much nicer. Right, icy road. Oh no, bushes have spun me Daewoo around. Go! Forward, car! Forward! There's some vehicles coming around the corner, so we're going to go back to some more off-roading. Right, well, it has been certainly a long way round, and don't tell me that's killed it instantly. Oh, yeah, that's... it's just too weak. It is just too weak. I tried to get on the road. It's dead already. I tried going off-road, but yeah, the car was just instantly killed the second it took a knock. That was, an unfortunate placement of the messer when I tried to get back on the road. I'm not sure this car is going to be able to survive the drive here. So, for the final attempt for the Daewoo, this car has got some issues. The problem with going off-road is while it stops the damage for a while, when you try and rejoin the road, you tend to be going quite slow, and that then enables any vehicles around you to absolutely muller the little car. So, if you can get lucky, you can do it, but you've got to get quite lucky. I'm now not sure whether the motorway is a better idea or whether off-road is a better idea. The motorway has its dangers. Off-road has its dangers. I think perhaps my best route is to stick with the motorway until the prison. In fact, what might be better even if we do what I did on the very first attempt, if we off-road our way across to the prison, we'll then head up the banking, not jump at a tree, because that was a silly thing, and keep off-road down there. We should be able to get into the city relatively quickly, relatively unharmed, and then see if we can outmaneuver them inside the city limits. That is what we're going for here. Unfortunately, it does mean we have to cross the motorway here, which is scary, scary prospect. Messer, go. I will then go. Messer's everywhere. Messer's done a front flip. I can't really look both ways. I've got to get going quite quickly. We're through, though. We're across the motorway, and we are going to go into the scrapyard. Hopefully not completely and utterly on our side this time around, which is good. Right, we're through the scrapyard. In one piece. There are quite a lot of army vehicles over there, so perhaps I won't... Oh, God, there's army vehicles everywhere! Come on, little Daewoo! Come on, little Daewoo! You don't want to let the mighty Daewoos down. They have done so well in the past in this series, but this one is looking like it is in trouble. For a minute there, I thought I saw fuel leaking out of the car already. No, we're good. We're fine. We're fine. There's lots of helicopters. However, we have momentarily got a little bit of breathing space. We're going to stick over here on the dirt. He's going to get across in time. Damn, I didn't even see some rocks down there.
uh-oh, we're going to go round and round in circles. I don't know what went with the Crusader. Crusader just kind of kamikazed himself sideways. Ugh. Get down the off-roady bit here. Everything is still giving chase. Too many vehicles around. Come on, climb. Climb, little Daewoo, climb. Ah, that's not a fun sight to see behind you, but we're still in control. Still in control. Cars have wildly spun. Okay, we're through. Please all crash. Please all crash. Right. It wasn't quite as cleanly through that part as we did last time, although the first time out. That was much needed the first time. However, oh, there's just a spin for good measure, I think, from... this car. Oh god, we're in so much trouble already. Fortunately, the damage, I mean, I bumped the front of the car on those rocks. I didn't realize there were rocks quite there, and it has lost the front bumper, but the wheels aren't bent up, the car's not smoking, the bushes have stopped us completely and utterly dead. Sake car, I can't be doing with this. This is the last thing I need. I need to keep the momentum, because the helicopters out here are doing a hell of a lot of damage. They didn't really care when I was on the train tracks. Why did we roll? Oh no, now we are smoking. I don't know why we rolled. I'm confused as to why the car suddenly decided. I know this is a FailRace video and stuff likes to roll over. Normally there is a reason. I'm taking the fence with me. Screw you all, I've got a fence. Oh, I've lost the fence. Never mind. I've lost the fence. Ow, that's going to hurt. We spun again. Still we go. Still we move forward. I'm not going to be able to get this bloody thing back into the city, I don't think. Oh, I've got to keep my foot down. This is the problem I'm finding. I've got to keep my foot down to keep the speed up, because otherwise the army cars... Oh, that's really solid. Okay, this thing just can't even go through them. That's problematic, really. Oh, get through the fence. Come on, car. We've almost made it to the city. Almost. Where did I get screwed over? It was somewhere around here. Yeah, there were trees and I crashed into them, so let's not do that one again. I think it might have actually been over here. No, rabbit, don't run in front of the fiery Daewoo. It's not a good idea to be doing that. Right, let's keep off-road for as long as I can, possibly, I think, is the safest option. What on earth is going on with that Jeep? I don't know. It just flung itself down here in the vague hope that I might be where it ended up. Oh, they got the fuel tank. It doesn't matter anyway. We made it to the city on this attempt, but they got the fuel tank and now there is an awful, awful lot of fire. Quick rabbit, run away from all of the army vehicles and we're gone. Bloody hell. Okay, this isn't the last attempt. I'm going to have one more go. I will try and make it back into the city without the Daewoo being on fire. Right, so very definitely the final attempt with this car. It's not strong enough. It really isn't. I must have got very lucky on that first attempt to make it to the city safely by going off-road. It is kind of working, but it still only takes one hit. And a couple of hits to seriously damage the vehicle. And we're just simply not fast enough to be able to outmaneuver the army to stop them being able to get it. Oh, come on, car! Damn it, I really was not expecting them to be able to turn. The army have done a good job this time out, I will say that much. They have done a good job. Please block the rest of the cars, thank you. Chasing this vehicle down, they've really made a nuisance of themselves. Right, we're going to go for a different tactic here. We're going to go for a very different tactic. Try and keep ourselves on the road for as little time as possible. If we go, oh god, no, go away, army vehicle. I don't need any more assistance from you guys. I really, really don't. No, don't spin and stop, you silly car. I mean, we managed to get our way, oh no, no, please leave me alone. We managed to get our way to the other side of the motorway without having to actually go on the motorway, but we have, whoa, flying car, flying me as well is bad. Ah, we nearly got landed on. That's a scary sight. Not a sight that you want. Oh, come on. Come on, Daewoo. We can do this. We can do this. Oh, no, he's going to block off the way that I wanted to go. Haha! I've put an army vehicle in the wall and my car is still in one piece. Ish. Not quite the same shape piece that it started in. Ah! They're coming from that way. But it is still in one piece. Oh, crap. I shouldn't be taking these jumps. I'm so used to kind of taking these route with normal cars and you just don't think about it. They're just fine with it. With this, that's when you get yourself into... Jesus, what on earth did he crash into? Or maybe they crashed into each other. I don't know. A big explosion, though, from some helicopters. Right, we are still bouncing around in the sand dunes. The problem is this off-road area where I'm having to go to try and avoid the damage. is some really quite nasty off-road terrain. It's very, very bumpy, and this car really doesn't like off-road, so I'm basically forcing a car to do what it really doesn't want to do, but it's better than trying to stay on the road, because otherwise it will fall apart. So, yeah, it's not really the best, the ideal situation that I have got myself in with this car. I'm really hoping that I was going to be quick enough. I just about judged that right through luck or skill, not sure which one. We were clear, though. We've almost made it to the prison. I'm going to stay off-road until the absolute last second down here, until the last second where I can get across and get up that hill. Right there, gone past. Let's get up this hill. Oh, so many army vehicles are causing problems. We're up. We're on the tarmac for the briefest of seconds before we will then go up another hill to... Please stop shooting at me. I could do without all of the bullets coming towards the car, quite frankly. Up this hill here. Right, don't roll the vehicle over. Don't go through any fences. Basically avoid everything with this car. The helicopters are not doing a very good job of keeping their engines alive. At least they smoke about as much as this Daewoo does, so that's kind of vaguely comforting. Oh, sake. Like, some of these bushes, I drive through and I'm fine. That was just like through the flower beds and it stopped it dead. And other times, I don't know. I don't get it. See, that one there, we were fine getting across. And I managed to get across the road at a better place. We will have to go through the ranch. We will probably have to break through one fence. But it's a thing we're going to have to do. Not really a better way of getting this way safely. There certainly isn't. Not for this car, anyway. There are much better ways of doing it. But, they've got the fuel tank already. I just saw the leak. Yeah. Bugger. As much as the Daewoos, as well as the Daewoos have done in this series previously, the Tico is too weak. It simply cannot survive long enough to get away from the army. The agility and maneuverability is good in the car, but the strength is not enough. I tried my very best. I tried my very best, but they were far too brutal coming after this car. It's too slow taking the routes, avoiding the motorways. It's too slow. The helicopters just puncture it with bullets continuously, and the routes via the motorways, via the roads, all it takes is one hit and you're pretty much out of it. So yeah, the Daewoos have not quite succeeded with everything. That car has failed them a little bit. It's a good fun enough vehicle to drive normally when the army aren't giving chase, but yeah, not strong enough for this sort of a challenge. Anyway, that is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.